Morning, boys. John Kerry, 1963 Jag, coming at you on a Sunday morning. I'm out in the shop. It's a little cloudy, hazy day today. No sunshine. It's just overcast. And I've been out here for 3 days. Well, this is my third day that I've been out here in a row. Yeah, you can see that's pretty, you know, solid gray sky. It's not so cold as I showed you, but a little cloudy. So I've been out here preparing more materials to be painted. And 3 days of work, well, 2 days of work, and I feel like I really didn't do anything. But every time I open up a box to sort of check the subsystem for component completeness, I find more stuff I need to plate. So that's Jag had a very interesting oil canister. There's a paper filter in there with a big long bolt that holds it into the side of the engine block. So I zinc plated all that. Here's some brackets for the water return pipe from the heater to the block. Some breather hose elbows, some clamps I found. The rear engine stabilizer mount, there's like a rubber bushing that goes in here and another one up here. And it stops the back of the engine from rocking back and forth. And these are my fuel float bowl overflow pipes that have been badly bent and mangled, but I plated them anyway. Actually, it helped me to have them curled up like that because I could fit them in my little plating tank. Here's my rear engine transmission mount cross member, which I didn't think I had, but I found it. And then this is the breather tube hose that goes from the crankcase back to the intake so that it can burn some of the oil fumes and stuff like that get generated in the crankcase, puts it back into the intake plenum. So that's what I've been working on. I mean, really, it doesn't look like a lot. I plated a whole ton of hardware too, nuts, bolts, washers, and I dug out my old my 3.8 engine component bin, and I found some stuff in there that I didn't think I had. So here's my oil filter mounting blocks. I have three of those. I have to figure out which one's right for my engine. And I got the blast cabinet going again, trying to clean off these brackets, but the paint they put on these things, forget it. I don't know what they're made of, but pretty insane. I also found my engine mounts, and the same kind of thing. I couldn't barely get the paint off those things, so I've been dipping them in acid to see if I can kind of soften the paint and get them off of there. So I wire brushed the outside, you know, so that's pretty clean, but down in that little V shape there, it's pretty hard to get at with a wire wheel. And I tried using a scraper, I couldn't get at it. Acid's not even denting it, there's no bubbles rising, so there's just not much going on down in there. I got my heat tank booted up, so I'm gonna get my degreaser cleaner heat it up, and then I'll probably boot up the plate tank again and do a little more plating. I'll probably plate this breather pipe. Although, interestingly, it's a steel pipe, you know, not anything magical. I'm wondering if maybe I shouldn't try and remake this or have it remade. It's perforated right here, as you can see. Can I get it to focus? Focus, baby. There you go. So there's a perforation there. And I had the same problem with the water heater, what they call the heater return pipe. I filled it with some rust remover to see if I could get the inside of it cleaned out. And as I was brushing off the outside paint, I uncovered this perforation here. And I think there's another one somewhere. There's two of them somewhere. So this is just a straight piece of pipe. I'm thinking stainless steel or even copper might be a way to go. It's got this little reducer on one end here, but that doesn't seem like that'd be that hard to make. That's a straight pipe, so there's nothing to it. Well, I'm pretty sure I'll just have that replaced rather than... That's why I stopped trying to clean it. So I got my heater core and my... that's the heater core down in there, and then my overflow tank back. This is not the original overflow tank. This is one that somebody had made, you know, folded sheet metal. Look at that. It's all solid brass and then soldered on the corner. So I had the repair shop resolder it, which they did. They cleaned it all up, pressure tested it, and said it's working now. I'm just not sure I'm going to use it because the one that's original for my car is supposed to have kind of molded, rounded corners, and it had a, I think it had a seam, you know, through the center of it, so it was made in two pieces that were stamped, and then it was press welded together. But I don't know. I can buy replacements. They're not cheap, $150, but I don't know. I may just decide later. I might just spray it in the hammer tone paint, stick it on there, and you know, see what it says. I have not touched my fuel pipe stuff, but I did confirm I have the right parts, so at least I know I've got the right stuff, so I can go ahead and get that thing in there permanent. And nothing much else on the car. I've really just been over here collecting material, making another list, long list, unfortunately, of spare parts and bits and pieces I need to finish the car. Jeez, it just goes on and on and on. Every time I get to a new subsystem, I start thinking, do I have this, do I have this, do I have this? And then if I don't, I've got to put it on the list. So anyway, it's good to see everybody. I saw Greg made a video, hasn't seen him in a while. There was a, is it David Cook that's got that old beautiful Mopar black car? He came out and made the video. So it was good to see him again. Rick Fix making a little progress. Chef Tush making progress. Tim's Beetle's been making a couple of videos. I like your new intro. That's pretty cool, Tim. I think I posted a comment. I like your logo. The two girls with their legs up in the air forming VW. That's pretty cool. And yeah, you know, just keeping up, watching David Ding put that Passat back together. Jesus. Seems like he's an expert on those cars, though, which is kind of fun to listen to him talking about all the little things that come up in those cars. Darren's feeling better. Great, great news. Good to see a couple of videos from you, Darren. Welcome back. Hope everything's going to go just the way you planned. So, Dave M.I.I., Dave Me, came by. He's a Triumph guy. If you don't subscribe to him, it's Dave M.I.I.I., little letter I's. He's working on an old Triumph TR6, and he's friends with Dave Tush and Neil and, you know, all the guys that are in the Triumph world. But he and I started talking a little bit because Jag and Triumph share a lot of raw materials and components, electrical systems, things like that. And he came by the other day, so we were hanging out in the garage doing a little bench racing, drinking some beers and talking cars and just generally getting acquainted. So that was kind of nice. Thanks for coming by, Dave. And you're welcome anytime. It's nice to know there's another guy nearby that kind of gets it, and I can call on him for help. And I offered him the same thing, you know, if he needs to borrow a tool or a pair of hands. I'm always at the ready. So anyway, it's Sunday, and I swore I was going to get out here really early, and I didn't get out here until almost 9 o'clock. So it's just a little after 9. I spent the first... Sorry about that, guys. I just turned off my camera, picking it up. So I spent the first half hour cleaning up out here because I made such a mess. And as I was cleaning up, I was vacuuming, you know, from my wire wheel and, you know, the debris that comes out here. And the vacuum fell off. I had it sitting up on that stool, and the reservoir cracked open. So all the dust and crap that I had cleaned up was all over the floor. So I had to do it twice. And then just, you know, I'm a big user of little plastic containers, you know, recycling from groceries and things like that. So this is some of the rust remover here. I got a little bin of new parts that I want to plate today. Here's an example of, you know, this was completely black with rust, this little bolt that goes through one of these clamps that I plated. And it looks brand new, right? Raw steel. But if I leave it like that, it'll become rusty. Here's an example of one I left out after I had stripped it bare, and you can see how it gets that little bit of flash rust on it. So those have to go back in the plating solution and get stripped. I mean, the acid will take that flash rust off. And then here's some magic clamps. I don't know if I ever told you guys this, but there's a brand name called Cheney, Cheney, that are used on Jaguars, and you can't just go get a new clamp and put it on there and be correct. So I've stripped and cleaned and replated all of these clamps that came off the car. They're really high quality. You know, you can see here they're the kind that they don't perforate the steel with the screw drive. So that's a real thick band, and it has these these screw drive lines. They're sort of stamped into it. I don't think it's a machine surface. I think it's a stamp. And so, I mean, they look nice when you brush them up and keep them perfect, but they rust. So I got to put some plating on them. So I've got three more here to do in this little bin, and then a bunch of little screws and nuts and bolts. And I was thinking I might throw a quick zinc plate on the pipe and the transmission cross member, and maybe these engine mounts. I don't know why, but probably not. I'll probably just put some etch on those guys. You can see there's nothing happening. Got to do another little wire brush on those after they come out of the acid, and then I'll probably etch, prime, and paint. I was hoping to get to my painting, put a coat of etch on some of these other items that are down here, because they're going to start getting rusty, or at least milky white stuff from the zinc. So I'll get to work on those, and I'll bring you back if something's interesting. So have a good day, guys. Everybody, make videos. Push the record button. Talk to you later.